Welcome to our fourth section, Data Binding and Security in Einstein Analytics. Bindings in Einstein Analytics. In this video tutorial, first we will remove filter from our existing dataset for opportunities with account. Then we will create a sample dashboard. After we create a sample dashboard, we will try to understand the bindings in Einstein Analytics, and we will try to understand how the components on the dashboards interact with each other. We will go through the faceting and broadcasting concept, and we will go through the feature connecting data sources. So this is a sample dashboard which we are going to create. So let's jump to our Einstein platform and let's get started. So first, create a blank dashboard. Click on create button, then dashboard, select a blank dashboard. Click on the gear icon over here. This will open up a panel on the right hand side for dashboard properties. We are going to add columns over here up to 30. Select the row height as fine and select the horizontal spacing as 0. Rename the dashboard to success dashboard. And rename the tab to home. Click on apply and do not forget to save. So before we start creating the actual visualization on this chart, let's go to data manager and remove the filters which we have on the data flow for opportunity with account data set. So click on analytics studio, which is a home for us, and then click on data manager. And from data manager to data flow and recipe, and then to our master data flow. So here we can see we added this filter node over here. So we will delete it. Now you can see it gives us the error because it is disconnected. So we need to connect the source node for a compute opportunity with the augment node which we have, that is the join opportunity with account. So click on it, add the source as join opportunity with account. Click on save, update the data flow, and let's click on run. Let's wait for a minute while it's running the data flow. And our data flow ran successfully. So we can again go back to our analytics platform and then to our success dashboard. So over here, let's drag and drop one chart widget from the widget panel. Okay. Let's do a little bit adjustments over here and click on the chart button in the middle. So the next window which will pop up, that gives you the option to select data set. So I am selecting opportunity with account data set. So if you go back to our chart, the sample dashboard, you can see we are going to create a horizontal bar chart, okay, by stage. So what we will do is we will change the measure from row to amount. And we are going to add grouping by clicking on the plus sign below the bar. Click on it and let's group it by stage. So now you can see, since we removed the filter from the data flow, now it is giving us all the stages over here. So let's order it by descending order. And then we will click on done. So when we click on done and click on the chart on the right hand side, you will see the general properties started appearing over here. So let's click on the legends and remove the legends for now. Do not forget to save. So the next we will add one donor chart. So click on the chart in the middle, and this time let's display sum of amount and let's group it by one, which is a true and false value. And what we will do is we will change the visualization to donut so that we will get the donut chart over here, and click on done. So next, add a pyramid chart, which actually gives the side by side view. So it's really better to use the pyramid chart when you need to show the comparison amount side by side. So initially what we will do is we will go to chart and we will change the chart type to pyramid. Okay. And then from the left axis over here, we will change the measure to your amount, and we will add a right axis. So let's say account, annual amount. Okay. But annual amount actually doesn't make sense. So let's add the custom amount over here, which is the half of the formula which we created. So now you can see the sum of amount and the sum of custom amount side by side. You can also group it by, let's say we will group it by industry. Okay, and let's sort it in descending order. Now let's say if I want to see the top five industries side by side, then what I can do is I can go to this query limit over here, click on edit, and what I will do, I will add a limit over here, let's say 5. So you can see it automatically updated, and it is giving us the top 5 industries and the side by side comparison for sum of amount and sum of custom amount. Let's click on done and just remove the legends for now. Nice. And finally, we will add one table over here. So we will add a table. So we have like, we can change the mode for a table to table mode from here. So we have three types of table: PO table, compare table, and the value table. We are going to use the compare table over here. So let's use compare table and select the measure as sum of amount. Then later let's group it by close date for a month, let's say, and click on done. So just to make this one looks good, we are going to change the property spacing to fit to visit. So basically it will fit over here. Do not forget to save. Once you save it, what we will do is we will add one more chart over here. Let's add a map chart over here. So drag and drop a chart. Go to chart. Change the chart type to a map. And will add a account billing country. Sum of amount. Let's click on done. Adjust your chart a bit. And from general properties, we are going to remove the legends. The Einstein Analytics also comes up with the few widgets which are used for the filtering purpose. So one of the widget is a list widget. So let's drag and drop a list widget, click on it, and over here you can see this opportunity with account. It's a data set. So let's change this data set to account, okay, which we have. And let's select the billing country over here. So if you go to preview mode, you can actually see the billing countries. There's one more filter widget, that is toggle. You can drag and drop, click on it, change the data set to our opportunity with account, and then select a one field and save it. So now let's coming back to our topic, bindings in Einstein Analytics. So bindings in Einstein Analytics basically enables the interaction between the different components on the dashboard. So you can control the interaction by binding the different steps and the components with each other. Now that we have created a dashboard, let's try to understand the bindings in Einstein Analytics. Bindings in Einstein Analytics enables interaction among different components in dashboard. Basically, we can control the interaction by binding. There are two types of bindings. One is selection binding and second one is the result binding. So in selection binding, basically you are depending upon your selection on one step, the result on the dependent step updates. So that is the selection binding. So if you want to take an example of that, let's jump to our dashboard which we created and go to preview mode. So for this particular toggle selection, we have true and false value. So now if I click on the false, one value on the toggle, you can see all the other components over here are updating. So this is a selection binding. So if I click on the donut, the remaining components also update. By default, the components from same data sets are connected to each other. So what I mean by that is, let's say I have a dashboard, and in that dashboard I have created, let's say, 7 to 8 charts. So all those charts will be connected to each other. So the same thing is happening over here, because except the billing country list filter over here, all the other charts or components are from the opportunity with account data set. So whenever I click on any of the component, the remaining components actually respond to it and updates. So this particular feature is actually called as faceting. So now what if I don't want to update a particular chart? So in that case, basically we can click on that chart. Then on the right hand side panel, I can click on step tab, and here I will see option apply filters from faceting. So I can uncheck this option and it's done. So now if I click on preview mode and if I click on a donut chart, you can see the horizontal bar chart and other components updates, but the pyramid chart didn't update. That is because we uncheck the faceting option. So similar to faceting, there is one more feature which we have that is called as broadcasting. So what if I don't want any other chart or any components to update depending upon selection for a particular chart? So what I mean by that is, if I don't want to update other components, if I select on this horizontal bar chart. So this particular feature is called as broadcasting. So what it is doing is, when you select a bar chart, that selection actually it is broadcasting throughout the dashboard. So similar to faceting, if we can disconnect a particular chart, the same way we can disconnect the broadcasting the selection as well. So for that, click on the chart step and you can see the broadcast selection as facet option over here. If you uncheck this one and go to preview mode, so if I click on any bar on this horizontal bar chart, the values for other components are not updating. So this is faceting and broadcasting feature. So let's remove those features. So let's check this broadcast feature. Let's check the faceting feature for pyramid chart so that everything will interact with each other. So now one thing, if you remember, we created this list from a different data set, which is account data set. So if I click on Australia, you can see nothing is basically updated because all the other components are part of opportunity with account data set, and only this list component is part of account data set. So in this particular scenario, how you can make the communication happen between this component? So for that, we have option, or we have a feature called connecting data sources. So in this option, basically we can connect two data sets together. So for that, you need to go to the right hand side top option where you can see the three horizontal dots. Click on it and you should be able to see a option connect data sources. Click on it. Click new connection and let's call it as account to opportunity. And I'm selecting, since I'm going to select from the list, what I will do is select the first data set as account. So in this particular window, by default, you will get all the data sets which are part of your dashboard. So in our dashboard, we are using two data sets. One is account and another one is opportunities with account data set. If you use three or four data set in a dashboard, those will also start appearing over here. So let's select on the account and then billing country. So billing country, and we want the billing, depending upon the billing country selection, we want the opportunity with account data set to be updated. So the matching value will be in the account billing. Save it, close, go to preview mode, and now let's select as Australia. And you can see your components are updating now. Do not forget to save your work.